and now the licensee section, all about H.C. Ford and Sons.
And as he walked to the corner, this is what I heard him say. Pencils for sale, brains made from nails, I'm sure I got something for you. Hollywood maps for tourists that are only passing through. Pencils for sale, brains made from nails, look them over, take your time.
Yeah, I mean, it is Henry Ford and Sons, apparently. Mm-hmm. But yeah, there's hardly anything. I've gone through all sorts. Could do with someone who's got an access to, you know, company's house, really, to see what is there, if you can go back that far. But I even went through the trademarks as well, to see if they trademarked anything. Very painful search engine. They did do some other stuff for other companies. I found a few oddities. But yeah, real hard to find any information on them. They must have just come and then gone. But it seems like they were going for a while, though. It seems like they had some roots in the 60s and 70s. So, but yeah, that's all I could really find. Very disappointing on that one. We've already talked kind of stationery already amongst ourselves. I actually did have the HCF pencils when I was a kid. And I was really annoyed at myself realizing, because I threw a bunch away about 10 years ago. I'd actually got down to, I think I had about an inch left on all of them. So I'd used them, as a kid, they were in my little pencil case, and I'd used them. And I just remember buying those the blue starry pencils. I had loads of them. And so they did.
It sounds like they'd had a good life, Pete. It served their purpose.
I used them in my A-levels. That's how long I had them. They just kept going. You know, I kept, you know, I'll use that for something. And they just stayed in my pants because for years and years. And I just kept, you know, another sharpen and then sharpen them again and then sharpen them again.
They've gone to a better place, that great pencil case in the sky.
Do you get the feeling that H.C. Ford is kind of seen as the poor man's Helix? Is that a fair comment or not?
I think it used to be. Not so much these days, because the way the prices have gone, there's a lot of people chasing it.
That's because I'm hoovering it all up. It's just forcing the market prices up.
There does seem to be a lot of that. I mean, you boys are hoovering it up. I mean, if you go on the Beyond the Toys, there's always an HCF post, one of you lot are buying it. Tons of it. I mean, there is a lot. But I think Jason's got a point there. I don't have any recollection of Helix in shops, but my local little corner shop was selling the pencil. That's what I was getting them for, because they were cheap and they were on the store display all the time. So I must have been picking these up locally. So they were everywhere, but I don't ever remember seeing any Helix stuff. I never had any Helix stuff, so that must have been downtown in W.H. Smith's, which I wouldn't have gone to because it had been, you know, going downtown. If I could pick a Star Wars pencil up locally, I would have picked a Star Wars pencil up locally. So, but the rest of you guys have any HCF stuff? Well, Richard, you would have been beaten up for it with a starry pencil. Crikey.
Mm-hmm.
But I reckon, I don't know, spoons, you must have, you definitely had HCF stuff.
I did definitely have HCF, and I've got very little of what I had as a kid Star Wars-wise. One of the things I still do have is just the case for my Han Solo Star Wars-scented eraser, a bit like your pencils. The rubber was completely, went down to nothing and was binned, but I kept the little case, and one of the first things, you know, when I got back into collecting kind of non-figures, was getting the is it the six in the set, the coloured Star Wars erasers. I didn't bother with the Return of the Jedi ones because I don't remember those, but I had the Star Wars run, and I also remember the pencil toppers. So I've always had quite a few of those as a collector, and variations of Han, Hoth and things. So I've always liked those. So, you know, I'm not a massive stationery collector, but I do have a good array of HCFs. I've got the kind of the gift pack with a couple of the pencil toppers in, the notepad, the pencil, Boba Fett rubber. That's quite nice. Picked that up from a toy fair not so long ago. And the the topper boxes, those Return of the Jedi pencil topper boxes, seem like 10 a penny. They seem everywhere. So I've got one of those. I would like the Star Wars one as well. With it's the pop-up Luke Skywalker on there, but I've never actually bought that one. But they mean quite a lot to me. So I've collected them for that. But I'm not interested in putting, you know, together all of the stuff like Jason's put. You know, I do like the look of it, but I just don't remember most of it. And yeah, these days I'm just trying to limit what I buy to, if it's British, to stuff I remember. Otherwise it's stuff that I just find genuinely interesting. So yeah, I can't see myself getting too much more of it, really.
Talking of pencil toppers, that was a concept I never got. Having a pen topper, I just, you see, you know, being a practical kind of family, that, you know, putting something on the end of your pencil that didn't really do. I mean, they weren't rubbers, were they? They were just pen toppers.
See, they were a big part of, like, for Father Christmas every year, we would get some. I've still got some. I've still got Kermit the Frog, and he was obviously on the top of a retractable pencil at some point, because he's got a big spike sticking out of his bum.
Ooh.
Where the pencil top got jammed up there.
Oh, dear.
And I used to have Batman and Superman pencil toppers that I just thought, well, great, it's like bringing toys to school. So you couldn't bring your actual action figures to school because teacher would tell you off, but you got these little toys in your pencil case that you put on the top of your pencil and fight with your mate that you're sitting next to.
Just showing off to me, that is. That's just showing off. That's just, oh, look, I've got a thing on my pencil. Never a concept I ever got, really, as a kid. I remember someone gave me I've still got it, actually. It's probably the only HCF thing I probably own. I've still got unless it's not them, I've got a Darth Vader pencil top. Someone bought it for me from somewhere and gave it to me at work, and it sat on my desk for years and years, and I still didn't use it as a pen topper. And I just thought, well, no, I don't remember those, but there we go. Right.
Speaking of the pencil toppers and Spoon saying that you could take those to school and play with them when you couldn't take the action figures, I don't know whether you guys have noticed that the pen toppers are based very, very closely on the action figure line, and some more than others. The Darth Vader, the cape is molded exactly the same as the cape on the action figure. So the arms sort of stick through the holes in the cape, and and you've got the little fold down flap on the back. So that's all reproduced in the molding on the pencil topper. The Chief Chirper is the same. The Chewbacca is the same. They're all really, really similar. The other one is the R2-D2. The R2-D2 pencil topper has stickers front and back, just like the action figure. And the sticker detail is, again, very, very similar to the R2 action figure. You can really, really see where they took their inspiration from. The main difference with the R2 is that the stickers you find on them mostly are upside down. You can find a variant with the sticker the right way up, but these things, when they were released, I think somebody at HCF thought that the correct way to place those stickers was upside down. So quality control, never their strong point.
I'm going to check mine right now, Andy. 2 seconds.
There's another lovely little continuation to that, because having molded the pencil toppers on the action figures, there's also a UK range of bootleg ceramic money boxes. And there's two different characters. There's a Vader and there's a Chewie. And you can get various different designs, slightly different details in the colouring and the glaze and the paint application. But these ceramic money boxes are based very closely on the pencil toppers, which of course are much smaller, and the pencil toppers are based on the action figures. So that continuation of design, that really pleases me.
Mine is upside down. I've never known.
Oh, it's gone upside down one. Are they more valuable if they're upside down, or less valuable if they're upside down?
That's the norm, yeah. That's
the norm. It's hard to find them with the stickers the right way up.
The Ewoks in particular, I've always thought that they just, from a distance, you would think they were the action figures. The detail is so good on them. I suppose because they're quite simple figures anyway, aren't they? Just two tones, hood and body colour. But yeah, they're lovely little items. So, and there is a lot of variations. So you get different size figures. So there's big Darth Vaders and little Darth Vaders. And Han Solo has as many leg colours as the action figure does as well. So if you're into your variants, pencil toppers are a great way to go as well.
I see lots of Star Wars logos. Apparently it didn't come out until, what, 82 or 81 or something?
It was 82 or 83. So this was part of the wave of product that was released towards the latter years of Empire Strikes Back having been released. We've talked about it on the podcast before, haven't we? I think when Empire came out, it suffered a little bit from the traditional view of sequels. The sequel was a cheap imitation of the first movie. It wasn't going to do as well. It wasn't going to sell as well. And a lot of the licensees were very, very shy of putting product out off the back of it. When, of course, Empire was released and was a massive success, the toys were selling really, really well. The third movie was on the horizon. People couldn't get enough of Star Wars, then a lot of those manufacturers were obviously keen to jump back in. But with Jedi still perhaps a year away, they couldn't market stuff with Jedi because a lot of the characters hadn't been released yet and a lot of it was under wraps. So they came back on board, not with Empire Strikes Back product, because I guess Empire was a bit old news. It was the last movie. They chose to come back with a Saga branding. So HCF's first product line, which as I say, I think is probably 82, although there is a salesman product sheet floating around, which is copyrighted 1983. So it may be that it was sort of early 83 this lot came out. But yeah, the first products have all got Star Wars branding, not Empire. And the artwork is all Star Wars. So you've got Luke and Leia in their classic white outfits and Hanley's smuggler outfit and Vader and droids and so on. No sign of Yoda, no sign of Lando, nothing at all from Empire makes its way onto any of these products. Other than the pencil toppers, where you've got Yoda and Han Hoth represented. But that's the only place in that first line where Empire creeps in.
So there's not a single mention of Empire Strikes Back.
Not a single mention otherwise, no. So for this first line, this, as I say, 82 or perhaps early 83, it's all Star Wars focused, and there is quite a clear colour scheme and branding running through a lot of these products. So they've gone for three colour schemes. They've gone for a blue and a red and a grey, and that repeats itself across a lot of these products. It's in the pencils, it's in the sharpeners, it's in the stationery sets. You've got Luke and Leia on the blue items, you've got the two droids, R2 and 3PO, on the red items, and then you've got Darth Vader and Stormtroopers on the grey items. That's on the tag pencils and the square pencils and the 4-in-1 pencils. The only things that are different, as I say, are the pencil toppers and then the character rubbers in the little plastic cases, which don't follow that red, grey, blue design.
In the first range, again, there's not a ton, but there is some of Han, but it's mostly droids. Luke and Leia, Han's not it's not Mr. Favorite Human, is he? Poor Han's getting left out, or left, right, and centre. Because as I go through it, erasers, as Ewoks come on, gone, so yeah, Han is not a big seller, is he?
He's not in that early range. No, he pops up on I think it's on he's on one of the pencil toppers. That's Han Hoth. And then the Star Wars version of Han pops up on one of these scented erasers in the plastic case. But other than that, no Han Solo at all in that first product range.
Poor old Han. So we won't go through every single thing, but in that first range, we've got scented erasers, pencil toppers, which we talked about, pencils. Now, is that my pencil with the starry sort of star design on the end, is it? When did that happen?
You might be talking about the square pencils, possibly, which had that sort of design. So they also had tag pencils, which had a little plastic thing on the end with an eraser and a little sort of flower-shaped tag hanging off with character images on. Mm. And then the other type of pencil was the 4-in-1 pencil. So you had four LEDs within the same pencil with different colours in. So I guess when you put your pencil on the paper, then you'd have different colours coming out.
Okay, so pencils are sharpeners and stationery sets. Nice. Are those still in? Do you find many stationery sets still doing the rounds? Because I imagine they have been ripped to pieces, aren't they?
Yeah, they're quite common. It's hard to find them complete. But you'll pick the basic stationery sets up relatively commonly, and not all that expensive. But as I say, to find them with all the contents intact, that's not particularly easy these days. And the shop display box for that one, that is one of the real rarities.
Uh-huh. So what from that first range then is anything that's completely impossible to get, or are they all pretty much achievable?
Yeah, it's all pretty much achievable. It's the display boxes that are tough. So you'll find the scented erasers and the pencil toppers display boxes relatively easy. The metal pots that the pencils came in, again, those pop up. I guess metal pots just last a little bit better than cardboard boxes. And then, as is usually the case, the bigger boxes are the ones that are harder to find because they wouldn't have been stored or kept so easily. So that's the pencil sharpeners and the stationery sets. Those are the two really tough ones.
Do you have these, Andy, or are you still on the search for them?
I don't know. Still looking for those two. I've got two out of the three pencil pots. I've got the pencil toppers. I've got the scented erasers, but not the sharpeners or the stationery set, sadly. Not yet.
Jason, how are you doing with this?
Pencil topper one. I've got one so far.
Oh. How's your early HCF collection coming on?
I've got that pencil topper box, and I've got two of the three domed sharpeners. I've got what else have I got out of that list? I'm missing two of the Star Wars scented erasers. And I'm probably needing a load of pencil toppers to fill up the box I've got.
Poor Jason. Right. So the second range, Return of the Jedi. You see, this is what I would have probably seen in shops then, finally, in my local shops. So, Andy, tell us about this second range then, Return of the Jedi.
Second range. This is where it all went a bit bonkers. Jedi was out really, really popular, and they had just thrown as much product as they could possibly get out there. Quality control went to pot, so it was a case to sell as much as possible as quickly as possible. So yeah, you've got all sorts. You've got three sets of erasers, you've got scented erasers, you've got record erasers, you've got character erasers, which are individually bagged. You've got the pencil toppers, so you've got six more pencil toppers. Very quickly, that's Vader, Akbar, Gamorrean Guard, Ewok, Royal Guard, and Bib Fortuna. More pencils. So the square pencils came back in Jedi boxes. There's also 12 pencils set in a cardboard box. Three different kinds of sharpeners, rulers, pencil cases. So there are two kinds of pencil cases. There's a plain vinyl ones in red, yellow, and blue, and then a larger pencil box. There's lots of different kinds of notebooks and memo books and so on. And pretty much all of those that I've mentioned up until now, they're all branded with the Return of the Jedi logo, and they've all got consistent design on a lot of the product and on the store displays. So it's a light blue background. You've got Darth Vader's helmet and then a space battle, TIE fighters chasing X-Wings. And that image is all over the Return of the Jedi HCF range.
I want to know, very quickly, what on earth was a record eraser about? I mean, I've seen these things, they're all over the place, but what was the... They're just nonsense, aren't they? Have I just got that wrong? I don't see the point of a record eraser. What on earth's going on there?
Jason, you got any idea on those? You got a few of these, haven't you?
It's not unique to Star Wars. You can get them for a whole range of different.
But why? What's the point of them?
It's like everything. It's collectibles. They're not for use. Any of these. I think particularly it was a girl thing at school. Remember, the girls used to collect scented erasers, all different shapes and things. And most of them are impractical. They were just there to collect like anything else. So you just have a nice box of your erasers. Those record erasers aren't even meant to come out of their packaging, are they, really? I've got one of those. It's a secret Santa gift. It's lovely. But, yeah, that's not for use. It's just to look nice. But
scented record eraser that I used, they do kind of disintegrate after a while, I seem to remember.
Yeah, I just don't... The entire concept of it just seems completely bizarre. I mean... You know, if you can't rub anything out with it, what's the point? It just seems big and horrible. I wouldn't have touched it with a barge pole. I wonder who came up with that idea. You know, like you said, yeah, I've seen them of all sorts of brands and things. I've never got it. I just thought, I guess records were popular at the time, I guess. And let's have a record eraser. That's it. That was the design meeting. I like there records.
There was a real fad for erasers, though, wasn't there, in the 70s and early 80s? You got erasers in all sorts of shapes and sizes and characters and so on. So, yeah, as you say, records are popular. Let's make one in the shape of a record. Why not?
It's just a bit bizarre that it's, you know, Star Wars. You thought, oh, maybe we'll do it in the shape of a starship or something, or Death Star or something, and make it bounce as well. I just found it a real oddity, to be honest with you. It just seems... Yeah.
But if you've already got the moulds for your record eraser set up...
I understand that. It's more the whole overall concept of a record eraser. But there we go.
Yeah, I've got none of the scented erasers yet. Are those harder to get than the Star Wars ones, Andy?
So
far. I'd say they're easier. You see more of them for sale.
Yeah, I haven't seen that. I haven't got any yet.
Definitely easier. The Jedi ones are much easier to pick up than the Star Wars ones.
Oh, I haven't seen one for sale yet. Record erasers, I've almost got my box now, so they're quite easy to get hold of.
I'll tell you what, I mean, think about how different the world was then, right? Back in the 80s, you see. Every single child would have had, I mean, that's every kid in the country. Apart from the Northerners, obviously. Any past, what, Leeds. They get beaten up. You know, virtually every single child would have had a bunch of, you know, you'd have to have your stationery in your little bag. These days, kids, you know, I mean, if I'm coaching at school, I'm going to fill in the register and I've got a pencil, I go, anyone got a pencil or a pen? Not a single kid's got a pen or pencil on them. Just like, well, how on earth do you survive? You know, oh, it's all on the computer, or it's all, you know, the pens are taken away just in case they don't come back the next day kind of thing. And you're thinking, wow, we were part of an entire wave of this stuff when, you know, this stuff was getting produced. And now, it barely exists, does it? Are they still churning this stuff out for kids?
It's the other way around, I would say, Peter. Actually, if I go into school right now, every single kid's got a pencil case full of stationery. You know, they've all got them. All of them. Everyone. Yeah.
Well, that's probably a northern thing down south.
Drummed into them.
Computers, Rich.
No, it's drummed into them because of exams. You know, it all has to be a clear pencil case, which is why Helix dropped the ball, I think, with their pencil cases. Because kids were never going to buy them. They had to be clear. They've got to be completely clear. No, stationery is a big thing. But you're right. As soon as they leave the classroom, why have a pen?
Yeah, just bizarre. There we go.
Continuing down the list, the character erasers, I've got all of them bagged bar the fair, and I've got a loose set. Pencil toppers, I've got a complete full box that I bought. There seems to be loads of those kicking around. Don't have any of the pencils. The sharpeners, I've got all of the three domed plastic ones. I've got all the oval ones. I haven't got the square plastic one. The ruler's quite easy to get. I've got that. No pencil cases. And I've got on the notebooks, I've got the mini memos box. And I'm about half full on that now. I've got the Star Logs box, but no Star Logs. And I've got the pocket memos, a set of three loose. And I've got a bag set of those. And I think that's about it, what I've got so far. And then I've got some other stuff that's coming that'll be in the next podcast, I think.
Now, just going back to the record erasers, if you've got the image or if you've got the actual thing in front of you, what's odd about the graphic on the front of one of the record erasers?
I'm just going to say something like it's mirrored or backwards or something.
But there's only two designs. Now, yeah. What did we say was missing from the HCF range? There's nothing from the Empire Strikes Back. And what is the image on the record eraser? This is the one with the blue background. So you're sort of looking over Vader's shoulder and you're looking towards Luke. Luke is on the gantry.
It's on Bespin.
On Bespin, it's the I am your father moment.
It is. That's an odd one.
What an odd one to choose.
That is very odd. Oh, I wonder why that happened. I'd love to know those sort of things.
I only ever display mine with record face out, so I wouldn't even know what's on the back.
Luke's looking a bit glum, isn't he, in that picture? He's got a nice hairstyle there.
Lightsaber. The colour's white.
Exactly. He's just about to get his hand chopped off. Bless him.
He's got the hand of the 1970s Luke Skywalker with the retractable lightsaber, isn't he?
Yeah, that's what I thought as well.
Yeah, that the lightsaber's gone right into his hand. He's got to cut your own hand off in a minute, mate. I think you better retract it, otherwise you're going to have you've got a missing hand already because your dad's just cut it off for you. But just looking at that record eraser, what an odd, stupid thing that is.
You don't see many shots of the back of Vader's head, do you?
Oh, I do. I tell you what I've just seen. I think if you see any, see one of these guys, it's not too expensive. There's Princess Leia perfumed eraser strawberry. I want one of those. That's awesome.
There's a few nice Leia bits. Have you seen, Pete? I don't know where. It's on one of the pictures that I posted in the Messenger earlier. There is a, let's get it right, memo pads. So the memo pads are these tiny little notebooks, little paperback books, and there are four of them. These are not easy to find by any means, these ones, but one of them has got an image of Chewie and Vader and Leia. And Leia is in the Ewok Village dress. How often does that outfit pop up on merchandise?
Well, doesn't her image appear on a little, on a, you know, a singular as well on a book? They seem to quite like that image, don't they? I'm sure I've seen it a few times.
It does. It's, you're right. It's on one of the mini memos as well. But this is a full shot. She's sitting down.
Yeah, because I've always been after that. Because one of them came up not too long ago. The Return of Jedi notebook with Slave Leia and Luke on the front, but I missed it. But I've always tried anything Slave Leia. But yeah, Ewok Village Leia is. I guess it's a more kind of suitable image of Leia, isn't it, to present? She looks nice, she's got lovely hair, you know, she's in a nice kind of Ewok thing, whereas, you know, Slave Leia.
But I thought you might like that one.
Right, there is something which we have to talk about, and hopefully you've got one of these, because I don't think anywhere in Star Wars do we have the word fancy. If there is anywhere, then I think you need to whoever knows it's there, but a fancy stationery set. I mean, fancy. I mean, talk about a word that's no longer used. That's a fancy thing. Ooh. You know, you never say, oh, Jason, he's quite fancy. Well, maybe
say that all the time.
But a fancy set. What a great word. And now, I bet you don't have that. Your fancy set.
Fancy stationery set. Yeah, well, there's two of them. I actually have both of those.
What?
One that is unused and the other one isn't. So yeah, two variations. So this fancy stationery set, it's a beautiful thing actually. It comes in a great big cardboard box. You'd think when you get a box that size, it's going to be absolutely packed full of stationery. But then you open it up, and what you got inside is a card insert with the contents vacuum formed to it. And it's actually fairly meagre pickings. You've got two of the inner cards. One's red, one's yellow. There are different contents to both of these. But, having had the promise of that great big box with the wonderful artwork on the front, you open it up and you think, oh, is that it?
Andy, fancy does not mean full of stuff. It means it's fancy. I mean, it's nice looking, a little bit posh. You know,
I don't know about that. It's the same tap they were shoving out and everything else.
Well, yeah, no, I understand that, but I mean, fancy doesn't mean it's packed. Fancy means it's fancy.
Comes in a nice box, Pete. I'll give it that.
Let's see what the definition of fancy is. Elaborate in structure or decoration. So that sums that up. A feel, a desire, or liking for. Oh, there we go. Yeah, I fancy some stationery. Not a lot of stationery, but I like the stationery. A superficial or transient feeling of liking or attraction. So you see that set and you go, yeah, I like it. But it's not in the kind of like, you know, full. So I think fancy was a good term for it. You know, it said, look, you ain't getting much out of this one, mate. You're going to get a few bits. They're going to look nice. We package in there and you can display that when you're 47. So, yeah. And you got a Paplu as well. So there we go. You can't argue with that.
There you go. So it's a fancy stationery box, if not a fancy stationery set.
You can't be a fancy then. What was the other? So there was two versions. What was the other version of it then? Slightly different colours.
No, they're identical boxes, and then the inlay card is different colour, so one's red and one's yellow. Ooh. And there was just different things on the red card from the yellow card. Don't ask me what was in each of them.
Oh, Andy, I'm disappointed with you. I was hoping you had two fancy sets for your life. Jason, you got a fancy set.
I haven't got any of the stationery sets yet.
What?
No.
That's very
just
cool.
Just starting out, me.
I thought you had a big, great big shout for this stuff. You must have a fancy stationery set. How do you sit on the fancy side of it, Jason? Is that fancy enough for you?
I haven't been really taken by the stationery set so far. I was kind of contemplating whether I was going to get any or not.
Oh, you've got to. You've got to get something with the word fancy on it.
I'm kind of starting out with that, you know, the little pencil sharpeners and erasers and stuff, and kind of working up to bigger things, I think, at the moment.
You disappoint me, Jason. Right, Andy, continue. Let's talk stationary sets, because I'm fascinated now.
This is at the point in the line where they're chucking stuff out as quick as they can and flog it on and flog it cheap. So pencil toppers gift set, that's the next one. These are square boxes, quite flat, only about half an inch deep. They were originally pencil toppers gift sets. So originally you'd get six pencil toppers, and then the other part of the box held a stationery set, one of the ones with the clear plastic covers that were left over from their Star Wars line, often incomplete. So you know, you'd have one of these sets with the erasers missing or pencils missing or something. But at least there was some consistency with the six toppers and then the stationery set. After that, they threw any old stuff in there. You could get random mix of contents. You could get pencil toppers, erasers, notebooks, pencils, sharpeners. I don't think any two are ever the same. Sometimes you find with other content. There was one that came up on one of the groups recently with a He-Man notebook in amongst the Star Wars stuff.
Ooh.
Just bonkers the range of different stuff that appears on these sets. You've then got carded stationery sets. Now, these are on card backs with the contents shrink-wrapped. Two different sizes, one's a bit bigger, one's a bit smaller. And again, random contents. You find all sorts on here. You find the pencil toppers, the erasers, the notebooks, the pencils, the sharpeners. And again, seems to be completely at random. Lots of those different ones about again. There is then a bit of an oddity, which is the HCF school kit. Now, everything else in the line is branded. You've got a nice header or a nice box or something with the Jedi logo and some Star Wars graphics. This one doesn't. The school kit has got a generic card. It simply says HCF school kit. With some white and yellow background. But having said the contents of the previous ones were random, this one isn't. Everyone comes bagged with a ruler, a pencil topper, and a set of three pocket memos. Why that was bunged out with a generic header on the bagged set, goodness only knows, but that's, as I say, a little bit of an oddity. And then just wrapping up the stationery sets, the other thing you can get are the catalogue packs, which are, as the name suggests, these are packs of stationery that you would have ordered through the Littlewoods catalogue or the Case catalogue or what have you. And it's basically a clear plastic bag sealed with a mix of contents. And in each plastic bag, you get perhaps an exercise book or a sketch pad with a little notepad and pencils and pencil toppers and erasers and things. That's another way that HCF stuff was sold.
So there was nothing on that clear bag, just literally a clear bag. So I guess none of those exist.
Literally a clear bag. No, I've got a couple of those. Sometimes you'll find them with stickers on, like, on some Argos products, you'll find the catalogue number. So sometimes you get little stickers with the catalogue number on there. But most of them are just the plain plastic bags, which is how they would have been shipped out, I guess.
Nice. So what's your favourite item in this range? What's the thing that you go, ooh, I love that. Best displayed item. What's the thing that really stands out for you in this range? It is pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, I like going back to the earlier range, the 82, 83. I like the stationery sets that would produce for those, the ones with the clear plastic cases with the tray liners and the bits and pieces in there. The red sets, the red droid set, the grey Vader trooper set, the blue Luke and Leia set. I think those are really nicely presented, displayed very well. So, yeah, that's probably my favourite from the HCF line.
I tell you what, I've just found a Gamorrean Guard Han Solo memo pad, because everyone thinks of the Gamorrean Guard and Han Solo together.
What other combination would you put on there, Pete?
Well, no other combination would make any sense, would it? That's the best combination of all time. Han Solo and his mate, Gary the Gamorrean Guard. Just find that really odd. Just hang on, what other combinations they got? I have to say, I do like the Leia mini memo pad.
Yeah, That one, actually, the Han Gamorrean, Jason just picked one of those up. That's the one notebook that I'm missing yet. So if anybody out there has got one of those, I would be extremely grateful to have one of those, please.
Well, obviously, I'll have to hold that as a bargaining chip for now. It's,
yeah,
it arrived, yeah. I've paid for it.
Destroy his life.
I did spot it at something like 4:15 in the morning and claimed it. So sorry, I was awake.
Early bird catches the worm and all that. There you go. Yeah. But if you want random combinations of characters, Pete, you've got to look no further than the mini notebook range. Now, mini notebooks are a little range of hardback. I mean, they are mini. They're about perhaps 2 or 3 inches square. But the characters on these four, you've got Ben Kenobi, you've got Lando Calrissian, you've got Boba Fett, and you've got an X-Wing.
Yes.
Now, who in the design department thought, if we're going to have a set of four notebooks, these are the four images going on the front? Is there anything you can think of that ties those four together?
Yes, actually. I think that's very... you've got the white man, the black man. You've got the droid, or, you know, somebody who's in a helmet. And you've also got a ship, so the ship's feelings aren't left out as well. I think it's perfectly sensible. The only thing it's missing is a creature, and they probably couldn't get the image right.
Well, I'm just guessing that people who were designing stuff didn't give a monkeys about Star Wars. Let's get it out there. Oh, there he's good. Put him on. Guys, for the rest of you, I mean, obviously Jason is mad and has loads of stuff coming up. Andy, you've been on eBay since we've been talking about this?
I haven't. Well, I haven't been on eBay, but I've been Googling the images. I'm actually on Andy P's website at the moment, just looking at his collection.
Stalking.
Yeah, I like them. I've got one of the fancy stationery sets. I've never really thought about it being fancy, but it's a nice group of characters. Got Emperor's Royal Guard, Darth Vader, pencil toppers, and the Boba Fett rubber. And they've got the Leia mini memos. It's a nice set. I've not been particularly inclined to add to that, but I am quite tempted, actually, looking at a lot of these things. As some of the sort of individually carded stuff as well. There's I noticed an image on Lulu Baru that Andy's got as well. So yes, just the mini memo and just the one pencil topper. They're quite nice with the dark Jedi heading at the top. I can see myself doing that. Actually, I prefer the later packaging rather than the earlier stuff. So it looks a bit, I think that the, because it's all bunched together, but the crayons and the pencils and those clear cases all looks a bit crammed in. I like the open spacing of the fancy packs. So
fancy.
Yeah, I quite like these. Yeah, I like H.E. Ford.
There was no, I just searched on SWC, there were no other things that have the word fancy in them. So that is a unique fancy product. So there we go. Rich, you've been persuaded by stationery. You won't get beaten up now. Well, you might get beaten up now, but you won't get beaten up now properly.
No, so... I'm losing all interest with non-toy related items. I sold off me mini memo pads. I had a full set of them. Oh. I had some pencil toppers as well. I'm actually waiting for the most outrageous statement that Andy Preston's put down in the show notes, but he hasn't got to it yet.
I was going to say, if you're going to try and hoover eBay, I've already hoovered the HC Ford off it about 2 or 3 times in the last month. So slim pickings at the moment.
Mm. So, Andy, what's this outrageous statement you need to release to upset Richard?
He's bottled it, is he?
No, he's gone video. He's gone video. Turn him off the video. Look, we can see he's naked. I can't believe he's naked.
There we go. Is this the bit about the pocket money prices?
Well, I'll let you read the statement out first, right? And then I want to hit you with a 1-2.
You go for it. So I was saying these things were available at pocket money prices. The stationery set, which would have been a scrapbook, a memo pad, ruler, pencil, and 2 toppers, £2.25. That was through one of the catalogues. And then the Star Wars Fan Club, you could also buy HCF through them. So some of their prices, that you could get those mini notebooks. These are the little hardback books we were talking about before. 50p each or 4 for £1.75. Pencil toppers, 40p or £1.60 for 6. That's not too bad, is it, Rich?
Richard's question here is, what does the term pocket money mean?
I used to get some pocket money.
Yeah, and they get beaten up for it 5 minutes later.
Yeah, I used to get some pocket money, and it was 5 pence a week. So for 5 pence a week, right, I could save up for a month and get a mini notebook, which would be filled after I wrote 4 words in it, right? I could save up for a year to get a fancy stationery set, right? Yeah, just pocket money prices, honestly. Ludicrous statement. Absolutely ludicrous.
Right, ignoring Richard. I've just seen that in your image. The one with Chewbacca, Darth Vader and Princess Leia, who's obviously pretending to be Slave Leia with a green dress on. Right, I need to find that. I want that now. That's definitely a Slave Leia image, pretending to be something else. So, Andy, you want to search? You got to find that for me? Let me know if the one comes up. Or is that rare as hen's teeth?
Which one's up, Pete?
The Return of the Jedi memo pad. It's got Darth Vader on it. It's got Chewbacca on it, and it's got Princess Leia in a green dress. There's no way that's pretending to be anything else. Right, where is it?
That is a bit hen's teeth, that one, Pete.
Oh,
I'll keep an eye out for you.
Ruined my life. Oh, you were supposed to say no. It's 50p.
10 weeks to see you up for it.
Oh yeah. Well, yeah. Exactly. Oh yeah. Gonna have to buy that.
It's no Han Solo and his best mate Gamorrean guard, though, is it?
It's not, but you know, Chewbacca, Darth, and Leia, well, not really best mates, are they? You know,
sounds like a winning combination to me.
Has anyone got anything else to add?
The only thing we haven't mentioned is the exercise books very quickly. So this was another thing that HCF put out with a totally different design to the rest of the line for some reason. Again, quite bizarre. So there are 5 different ones. There's a scrapbook, 2 sketch pads, large and small, an exercise book and a notebook. These have got a black background with red trim, red Jedi logo, and on the front of each they've got movie stills, not the illustrations on the rest of the line. So absolutely no connection to the rest of their product line whatsoever. Nice to collect. They come up fairly readily. They're fairly cheap. I don't know whether they had a different designer working on those or whether they deliberately decided to go a different way. No connection design-wise at all.
Yeah, I'm starting to see a trend there. I would imagine they had just different departments just churning this stuff out. How odd. Right, anyway, brilliant. Well done, Andy, with all that stuff. And we'll do something else next time. Bye.
Grab yourself one of those delicious podcasts next time you're on the internet. Our flavour is the Vintage Rebellion, and you can find us from the usual vendors.